Alright you guys, welcome back to the channel once again. Today's video, I want to check out this animated short that I have been very intrigued to check out. Okay, I'm not sure if it's a horror story or if it's a drama story, but I'm very, very interested in checking this out and give my thoughts on it. And I always like to watch these kind of little short stories because, you know, it really gives me inspiration as an artist as well. So I'm always very, very happy to check out also different styles of animation, different takes on horror, or, you know, just different animation styles and things like that. So this one here I want to check out today is called Holy Men, okay? And it is by Cosmogonique, if I did not butcher that. Hopefully I did not do that, but this one here is by that channel. If you guys want to go ahead and give them a follow, I will link the video down below this one so you guys can check it out on your own time and you will see what channel this is from originally. But I want to definitely check this out right now and give you guys my thoughts right after. And also, if you guys have any recommendations for other similar shorts like this, if you guys, you know, some of my viewers, if you guys are into shorts like these or horror shorts or just really good animated storytelling, or it could be live action as well, drop them down in the comment section. Let me know what recommendations you have for me, okay? But in the meantime, let's go ahead and jump into this one and see what it's about. Adriatic animation. Very dry environment, huh? Very deserted. Holy men. Smoke blurring the... like a mist. What the heck is that? It's a smoke from below. Oh, what the heck? Little things just moving in the air that it looks like a little ball or like a some kind of orb. She clearly wants no part of that. Okay, so that's the man driving on his motorcycle that was in the water. Is she like waiting for him? Oh. Yeah, she looks like she's waiting for him. I don't even know if it's he or she, to be honest. Did he shut off his engine? Wow, he shut off his engine, huh? So I guess she doesn't see it. Look at that, she keeps pushing that orb away. What is that thing? Like something futuristic, I guess? Oh, he's there now. Oh no! He took the dog! Oh no, he took the dog! Oh, she saw him. What is that thing, the balloon? Is that like some kind of animal balloon? Like, it looks like a squirrel to me. Is that an inflatable thing? there. What was that black stuff coming out of her? So it looks like they crashed into some kind of like portal or something, and she ended up in that place. That was weird. Is that a bunker? Seems like something infinite, you know what I mean? Like a hollow infinite world, something like that. This is like vibes I'm getting from the environment design here. Really good, very well done. Huh. Got cracks in it all over the place. Okay, she got to a cave. Oh, there he is! Well, he looks pretty chill for just finishing escaping or running away or whatever, driving away from that girl. Her. He's not even phased. You guys see that? He's not even phased. Oh, he has them in there. All of them. Some kind of containers. Ooh, she gonna... Huh. Wow. Oh, what? What happened to them? What is that thing that he has? Okay, looks like he sent her to... Oh, he sent all of them back. And then there's the thing he had at first in the beginning, right? Where he was using it on the ground to like causing the vibrations or whatever to like take the people. Thank you. blew up the inflatable thing. What was that? What kind of animal was that? I wonder what it was. It looked like a squirrel to me or something. Oh my god. She's gonna swim in the water. Is it a guy or a girl? I can't even tell. The character. I think it's a young, I don't know. But now there's, now that character's in the water. Just like the man in the beginning. Okay, time to give you guys my thoughts on this. This is well done. Good job, you guys. And no dialogue either. This was just all, you know, what is it like? Just movement acting, like body language and all of that. Well done. All right, you guys, there you have it. That was Holy Man. So let's talk about this really quick. The animation style was just really, really good. It was so fun to watch, very comforting for the eyes. I love the silence of the animation. All you can hear is like their movement, you know, like there's the way like the feet interacted with the ground, like the sounds of the water, you know, when they showed like the lake, like all of these little sound effects with you know, throughout the story here, just worked really well, and I really enjoyed that. So I noticed also that there is no dialogue whatsoever, but that's okay, you know, because the body language, like all of the acting, just with their movement, right? It actually explained a lot, you know. I can tell what emotions they were going through or lack of, you know. So I mean, all of this was pretty easy to understand, but I mean, it was all just really clear. It was well done. I mean, some things I'd have to really, you know, sit down and think about, or just rewatch this again to just understand it a little better. But from what I saw is that there's a lot of symbolism in here. There's a lot of symbolism in this story that was just not directly explained to us, or just directly shown right to our face. Like, or maybe they were, we just didn't understand them. But I understood something. I understood something deep, and I'll explain what it is. So let's just start with the environment. Really, really dry, right? It's like a very deserted place. It almost reminded me of Mad Max, very apocalyptic, you know, on almost like end of days, where there's a little bit of people left, you know, in certain areas. And they have to wear specific clothing for the environment as well, you know, very covered up and all these kinds of things. It's what I kind of got out of this. But okay, so it starts with this environment, very deserted, very dry. And we get this man coming out of the water. Now we know that this here is called Holy Man, right? So that's like, from what I understood, is that that phrase or that term, Holy Man, it relates a lot to the people, to the man that was in the water. So from what I understood, so we get the man coming out of the water, and this looks like a young girl character that's spying on him or watching him from a distance with her goggles. And all of a sudden this like steam comes up and covers up the like, you know, her ability to see the man in the distance. So she thinks it's her like lenses. She kind of wipes them off, but it actually is like smoke coming from beneath her. And so she notices that and goes down below the building or down the stairs. And the building that she's in, it's made out of glass. Like, it's just got nothing but glass walls or whatever. So you can see right through the building, and you can see that it's a very simple building. You can see all like the floors. And two men working on, it looks like the bottom or the middle floor. They're working on something, like one's welding, the other one's working on something that's, you know, obviously causing smoke to go up into the air. And, you know, they're just kind of doing their thing. And then this this character that, you know, the story is focused on a lot. So this young girl, what looks like a young girl, is she, you know, goes downstairs and she has her dog with her. And so she realizes that this man that she was looking at, like that was coming out of the water here, he now is on his motorcycle. He's dressed up and he's, you know, driving away, and she's watching him. but then eventually loses sight of him, you know, and so she ends up getting kind of annoyed. But I was gonna say, as she's watching him, she's, you know, sitting down right below this big inflatable thing that's outside. It looks like, you know, it looks like some kind of like store or like a dealership almost kind of thing, reminded me of it a little bit, where they're promoting something. You got this big inflatable character that represents the company, but I didn't understand why that was there. Somebody explain, you know. I didn't even read the comments below this. I need to like read the comments below this after this, but after my thoughts here. I normally just say my thoughts right before I read the comments, because I read comments sometimes before my thoughts, but this time I kind of just, you know, did it on my own here, because I don't want any spoilers. I want to just kind of give you guys what I got out of this, you know. So let's see. Okay, so yeah, she's sitting under this inflatable character thing. It looks like a squirrel to me. And I mean, you know, I don't know what that represents, but it looks like it's some kind of symbolism. But anyway, she's there, and then when she loses sight of this man on the motorcycle, she just kind of like, you know, brushes it off, whatever, goes away back into the house. And there's this like thing following her around, which looks like a little white like orb ball or something that's just kind of floating around following her. And she doesn't seem to be interested in that. Looks like she's been around that place for a while, and she's just getting kind of sick of that thing following her around. So from what I got is this, where she is located, it's this very like futuristic, fancy kind of building. And you know, they have like technology going on in there. There wasn't much shown, really. It's just this orb and then these two men working on things. I don't know what exactly they're working on, but they're just kind of doing their thing. And this building here just looks like a simple building, but it looks like, you know, kind of fancy. And she just goes back in there, or something like that happens, right? And so eventually, oh yes, as she's going back into her room, right, we just kind of get the dog that's following her up there, and then the dog stops following her, you know, because she goes into her room or something. And so as the dog is making his way back down the stairs, we see the man that was on the motorcycle outside, right? Eventually he reaches the building where the young girl is at, and he's right outside of the building, right by the inflatable thing, right? It's this thing is just shown over and over again. So right by the inflatable thing is he's just standing there, or you know, kind of what is it called, like squatting down or whatever, so he's not seen. And he pulls out this device, which he, you know, then, you know, puts onto the ground, and then it vibrates. And then, of course, the dog that's walking down the stairs, he now gets like, he just disappears. Looks like he kind of did something to like, you know, I don't know, make him disappear. He just, I don't know, sucked him into a vortex or something. I'm not sure. But yeah, the dog disappears, and eventually the same thing happens to the two men that are working. They both disappear as well. So the young girl notices. And once this man takes everybody from the building, the people he saw, he gets on his bike and drives away. The young girl notices him there, right? From the top floor, she notices he's down on the bottom there by the inflatable character thing. And then she runs down, hops on her bike, and follows him as well to, you know, wherever he's going. And eventually, during the chase, they run into this thing that's just kind of there in the middle of the road. Looks like a different, you know, what's it called, like a portal, right, to something different, because as they're driving, they both kind of just clash into it, and then they appear on another side, which is like a big drop. It's just like a big drop with a ladder leading up to you know, another environment. So the girl, well, first the guy, he runs into it with his motorcycle, then the young girl runs into it, and then she flies on and clings onto a ladder, and her bike falls onto the ground, you know, onto the abyss. And she like just decides to ignore the fact that she's somewhere else, unrecognizable. She just continues to climb the ladder, you know, very curious of where this man is going, and of course chasing after the people that he took with this device thing that he has. It's like some kind of magnet or something. And she climbs the ladder. So now notice that when she gets to this environment, it's very different from hers. So you see that this environment here, it's very broken. It has cracks all over the ground. It's almost like falling apart, you know, and it looks like it's on this big hill. So, you know, she goes through like up the ladder, into this, oh, what's it called? It looks like a, well, she opens up a shack, right? And then, or whatever, a shaft or whatever you call that, opens it up, right? And then climbs into, what looks like a, oh my God, what the heck? Bunker. So she climbs what looks into a bunker, she climbs what looks like a bunker, right? She goes into a bunker, and so once she gets, you know, down to the bottom here, down to the bottom, she sees a hallway in the distance, goes through the hallway, and then there's these curtains that are flowing, right? There's like a breeze right on the other side of these curtains down the hallway. She walks down there. Eventually, she gets to the curtains, and then as she is looking across, there's just a big drop, and then on the distance, there is there's the house, like on top of a hill or something, very very old, you know, broken down and all that, very very old house. So she climbs down the ladder and eventually makes her way to this house, you know, leaping over cracks and all these kinds of you know, over drops and things like that, where it's like split, the ground is split open. And she's spying on this man. Eventually she finds a man that, you know, captured these three people in the building that were with her originally, in the big glass building. And as she's spying on him, eventually she realizes that he's like experimenting on something. He's doing some kind of thing in there, like a lab. He's like in a lab or something. And he has the three people that he got inside these containers, these weird containers looking things. It kind of, to be honest, it kind of reminded me of like when they show that Pepto-Bismol commercial and they show like it going through the stomach, you know, and then down through the rest of the guts or whatever. I don't know. I just, it reminded me of that right away. But we see these, you know, the three people stuck in there. And as he's climbing up this ladder to, you know, pour something down these three containers, he notices the girl spying on him. But I noticed that it doesn't faze him at all. It's almost like he doesn't even try to run away from her. Almost like if he wanted her to follow him. You know what I mean? That's kind of what I got, because he wasn't trying to do anything. Even when he noticed that she was there, he just kind of like continued doing his thing. But of course, this character, you know, our protagonist, our main character, doesn't understand what's happening. So she goes and, tilts the ladder where he's on to drop him. But by then he had already dropped this liquid down the containers, covering the dog and the two other humans, the two other men that he took. And so what she does is, after she knocks the ladder down, reaches for a hammer and tries to hit one of the containers. But then she gets sucked in there, magically, it was hard to understand. I was incomprehensible. I couldn't comprehend what was happening at that point. I don't know how she got sucked in there, but eventually she did. And so then they all just get flushed into this like triangular, almost like diamond looking thing with the light, you know, just get flushed into a light. And then of course they end up at the end back into where they started, right? Well, at least the dog and the two men end up in the glass building, and this main character ends up out in the road, right, in like a hill. And then now we realize that she has this tool that the other man had originally in the beginning of the story here. Now she's carrying it. And so from that part, what I understood is that she was like next to carry over this, you know, kind of like passing down the torch or something. I'm not sure. The man that was there in the beginning, he looked kind of, you know, not too old, but he already looked like a middle-aged man, or, you know, above that or past that. So I guess since she was really young, she was next to do the same thing. So now we have her holding this tool, and she goes into the lake and does the same thing that this man was doing in the beginning. She dips herself into the water and then just swims away. And the other characters end up back inside the glass building. And they kind of open their eyes, like they kind of wake up out of a trance or something. So at that point, I was a little confusing on what was happening there. But from what I understood is that this young girl was meant to follow this man into this, you know, this weird environment he was in, you know, very old and broken down and all that, and to eventually end up in his position at the very end. And now she was next to carry that. So from what I understand is that, based off of the title, Holy Man, right, which is just kind of like a neutral term for everybody that's holy, is that this young person was finally chosen to do the same thing that the man was doing in the beginning. And eventually she would do that same thing where she goes into different areas and then just kind of like sucks people in to take them into another lab or something. I'm not sure. But based off of the actions of this man in the beginning, it seemed not evil, but not good. It was just hard to understand what was happening. Why did they suck these characters in and then flush them back out, you know, and through these little containers, flush them back out to where they were in the beginning. Did he do this for a reason, like to, I don't know, to like renew them, or I'm not sure, honestly. Like, all I know is that these characters ended up in the same location, the dog and the two men. And our protagonist was now in the same position as the man. So now she was the chosen one, I think, is what I was kind of getting at. And she was just sent out to save others. I don't know. That's kind of what I got. That's as far as I can understand. Now, I will be kind of reading through the comments here and then seeing what I can understand from it. And then I can come back and kind of clarify. Okay. So based off of a comment I read down below, it was very close to what I thought. Pretty much the same thing, but with more explanation. So it looks like this man that was in the beginning, right in the beginning of the story, that was that had this device, as this tool, he was a holy man that was actually living outside of the Matrix. You know, notice that he was by himself and these other people were in this like glass building, just kind of doing their own thing, just living life. And the inflatable character that was outside represented this big giant like bubble. Now, the reply that I read here, this person was, you know, just kind of taking a wild guess or an educated guess on this, which I thought was really, really good, you know, and I think it makes a lot of sense. So this thing represented or symbolized just like this big bubble that needed to burst at the end, which I did forget to mention on my, you know, on my thoughts before this. This, you know, when she points the tool down to the ground again, this bub, this character that's there, it begins to inflate and eventually burst and just kind of fly off into the air. So what this person said, based off of what they said, is that this thing that burst just represented the thoughts and all these ideas that were trapped and they just needed to break free, you know, and that the people that were in the building were stuck in this matrix, in this thing where they were just blind, you know, and they needed saving, but they didn't realize it. And these people that were out there swimming in the water that were actually not surrounded by dryness, right? All this like lack of water and lack of things, you know, inside this fancy building, of course, but they didn't have, looked like they didn't have any water. So in the end, when this character ends up in the water, that represented like a saved person, you know, outside the matrix, a holy person, of course, holy man, right? And then this person was sent to save these people from the matrix, which was represented by this big glass building and technology and, you know, just going to work every day, day in, day out, right, kind of thing. So I thought that was a really good explanation from this comment that I read and, you know, several others. But this one stood out to me the most. This one gave a more clear explanation. And I think that's very much what happened here. I think this person is absolutely correct and, you know, definitely connected to what I thought was happening here. But again, I didn't have that you know, that deep of an understanding that this person did. So I thank you so much for clearing that up for us. And also, I hope my explanation also clears things up for you guys that were watching it with me. I know this was a very long answer or a very long reply for this film, a very long thought, but I thought it was very interesting. And I actually liked that even the lack of dialogue didn't make it confusing. I think even if there were dialogue, it would still be something you'd have to look deep into, you know? So I think that this was something that made a lot of sense that, you know, we need to think about, you know, day, you know, in our daily lives, kind of escape the fancy buildings. What do you call it? They called it the concrete jungle, right? And then just kind of go into the actual, like, you know, wilderness or like the forest and the trees, kind of get back to reconnect to who you really are and then go purify yourself in the water. So, I mean, I really did understand all these things out of this story. And again, notice that the environment that these people were in was very dry and very hot looking, you know? So I really love how in the end, the character, the protagonist, ends up in the river, you know, washed and purified and all of that. So thank you guys so much. Those are my thoughts. I will stop talking now because I can keep going in circles here. So thank you guys so much for watching this with me. And I will see you guys on the next reaction. Let me know what you thought down below. Let me know if I missed something or if these other comment that I read also missed something. Or you could just tell me, you know, I mean, leave that comment as is. Tell me what I missed and I will definitely respond to that. So thank you so much, you guys. I will see you on the next reaction. Take care of yourselves. Peace.